So now we'll discuss inequalities of greatest integer functions. Suppose I have an integer a and I have four cases. Case one, when greatest integer function of x is greater than or equal to a. Second case, when greatest function of x is greater than a. Third case, when greatest integer function of x is less than or equal to a. And the fourth case, when greatest integer function of x is less than a. Now in each of the case, a is an integer. Now I'll take up the first case. When I say greatest integer function of x is greater than or equal to a, what I know is greatest integer function of x can only take integral values. So the kind of integral values it can take is x can be either a or a plus 1, a plus 2. So if greatest integer function of x is equal to a, then x lies between a and a plus 1. Its value is a plus 1 when it lies between a plus 1 and a plus 2. Again, when it lies between a plus 2 and a plus 3. So if I look at this equation, then I know that this x should be greater than or equal to a. So if greatest integer function of x is greater than or equal to a, then the simple result will be x should be greater than or equal to a. Say for example, if I say, so greatest integer function of x is greater than or equal to 2. So either greatest integer function of x is 2, or greater function of x is 3, or greatest integer function of x is 4. So it is 2 when x lies between 2 and 3. It is 3 when x lies between 3 and 4, it will go on. So it will start from 2 and go all the way up to infinite. So answer to this question will be simply x should be greater than or equal to 2. So either we can do it using logic, or we can simply remember the result. So if greatest integer function of x is greater than or equal to a, then the result is x should be greater than or equal to a. Now what if greatest integer function of x is greater than a? Now in this case, when greatest integer function of x is greater than a, then the minimum value of greatest integer function of x will be a plus 1, then a plus 2. So now this value is a plus 1 when x lies between a plus 1 and a plus 2. When it lies between, it will be a plus 2 and it will lie between a plus 2 and a plus 3. So that is, its value should always be greater than a plus 1. So in this case, answer will be x should be greater than or equal to a plus 1. So that's your direct result. Suppose I say greatest integer function of x is greater than 2. So that is, greatest integer function of x can take the value 3, 4, 5. So it will be 3 when it lies between 3 and 4. 4 when between 4 and 5, it will go on. So in this case, the value of x should be greater than or equal to 3. So either use logic, or we can use the result directly. If x is greater than a, then if greatest integer function of x is greater than a, then x is greater than or equal to a plus 1. Now what about the third case? Now in the third case, when I say greatest integer function of x is less than or equal to a, then greatest integer function of x will take all the values, so a minus 1 and then a. It'll take the value a minus 1 when it lies between a minus 1, a minus 2, a minus 1. It'll take the value a minus 1 when it lies between a minus 1 and a. And it will take the value a when it lies between a and a plus 1. So from here, the result I'll get is the value of x should be less than a plus 1. Now say for example, suppose I say greatest integer function of x is less than or equal to 2. So here I know greatest integer function can take the values 0, 1 and then 2. So it'll take the value 0 when it lies between 0 and 1. It'll take the value 1 when it lies between 1 and 2. It'll take the value 2 when it lies between 2 and 3. So from here I can say the value of x should be less than 3. So when greatest integer function of x is less than or equal to a, then simply x is less than a plus 1. So in this case, x is simply less than 3. And the fourth case, that is, when greatest integer function of x is less than a, so in that case, greatest integer function can take the values, there'll be a minus 2 and then a minus 1. Now it cannot take the value a. So it'll be a minus 2 when it lies between a minus 2 and a minus 1. It'll be a minus 1 when it lies between a minus 1 and a. So from here, I can simply say x is simply less than a. So if I say greatest integer function of x is less than 2, then The value of greater function can be 0, 1. It cannot take the value 2. 0 when it lies between 0 and 1. It'll be 1 when it will lie between 1 and 2. So from here, answer I'll get is value of x should be less than 2. So when greatest integer function of x is greater than or equal to a, answer is x is greater than or equal to a. When greatest integer function of x is greater than a, answer is x is greater than or equal to a plus 1. Third one is when greater function of x is less than or equal to a, then the answer is greatest integer function of x is less than a plus 1. And for the fourth one, when greatest integer function of x is less than a, then it is simply x is less than a. If you like the video, consider subscribing and sharing it with someone you know who might benefit from it. Also, the best way to navigate any topic is through a playlist. Simply go to the channel page, click playlists, and select the topic you wish to study.